各位，你们听说了吗？美国向中国索赔18万亿美元，你们的房子、你们的车子、你们的地都归美国人了啊！而且呢，好多的中国的网友非常的通情达理，一致的说要赔。那位师姐，别他妈胡说八道了，这哪儿跟哪儿啊？你看见了没有啊？你看啊，是这样啊，华盛顿最新的一份智库报告表示说，新冠造成了美国18万亿美元的损失，要求北京负法律责任。本台从来不胡说吧？那位说，谁说要赔的呀？把这些网友这个给我找出来，点天灯啊！这些网友纷纷表示赔，一定要赔。有说赔个毛的，有说赔个屁的啊，有说干脆撸一管赔给美国得了啊，18万亿美元啊！啊，好吧，我们看看这到底怎么回事啊？华盛顿的一家智库的一份新报告称，新冠病毒大流行已经给美国造成了价值18万亿美元的经济损失，建议美国政府就北京的失职和不透明采取行动，要中国政府为此负起法律责任。这份报告呢，是由保守派的智库传统的基金会在7月8号发布的。这个是由谁呢？是由这个中国和新冠疫情无党派委员会的主席，是前美国国家情报总监约翰，成员包括多位川普政府时期的高级国员，包括前国家安全顾问是罗伯特·奥布莱恩，还有前副国家安全顾问傅明。就是那个伯明，我老说傅明啊，极端反华的那个傻缺啊，那个还演过什么《北京人在纽约》那傻缺啊，说前美国疾病预防防治中心的主任罗伯特啊，你看都是一些极端反华的疯子组成的啊，建议呢国会和白宫采取行动，要向中国政府对美国及人民造成的伤害提供赔偿，建议专门成立一个索赔委员会，好吧，那位说他们说这个有道理吗？什么道理啊？这业界人士都看不下去了，都说他妈这美国这倒打一耙呀。
In 2002, the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, patented, and I quote, an infectious replication defective clone of coronavirus. Listen to those words, infectious replication defective. What does that phrase actually mean? For those of you not familiar with language, let me unpack it for you. Infectious replication defective means a weapon. It means something meant to target an individual, but not have collateral damage to other individuals. That's what infectious replication defective means. And that patent was filed in 2002 on work funded by NIAID's Anthony Fauci from 1999 to 2002. And that work, patented at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, mysteriously preceded SARS 1.0 by a year. Dave, are you suggesting that SARS 1.0 wasn't from a wet market in Wuhan? Are you suggesting it might have come from a laboratory in the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill? No, I'm not suggesting it. I'm telling you that's the facts. We engineered SARS. SARS is not a naturally occurring phenomenon. The naturally occurring phenomenon is called the common cold. It's called influenza-like illness. It's called gastroenteritis. That's the naturally occurring coronavirus. SARS is the research developed by humans weaponizing a life system model to actually attack human beings. And they patented it in 2002. And in 2003, giant surprise, the CDC filed a patent on coronavirus isolated from humans in violation, once again, of biological and chemical weapons treaties and laws that we have in the United States. And I'm very, very precise on this. The United States likes to talk about its rights and everything else and the rule of law and all the nonsense that we like to talk about. But we don't ratify treaties about, I don't know, defending humans.We conspicuously avoid that. We actually have a great track record of advocating for human rights and then denying them when it comes to actually being part of the international community, which is a slightly problematic thing. But let's get something very clear. When the CDC in April of 2003 filed the patent on SARS coronavirus isolated from humans, what did they do? They downloaded a sequence from China and filed a patent on it in the United States.Any of you familiar with biological and chemical weapons treaties knows that's a violation. That's a crime. That's not an innocent oops. That's a crime. And the United States Patent Office went as far as to reject that patent application on two occasions until the CDC decided to bribe the Patent Office to override the patent examiner to ultimately issue the patent in 2007 on SARS coronavirus.
这简直是触目惊心的贼喊捉贼啊，怪不得中国的网友愤怒啊，令中国网友愤怒的还有一个，这个中国公布了说美国伪造了一个所谓的中国黑客组织，他们和微软串通出了一份报告，说有一个黑客组织专门攻击美国的目标是中国的，可是后来呢，证实这都是伪造出来的，这个黑客组织根本就不存在呀！中国的网友更气愤了。
深夜，研究计算机病毒的朋友发来一个链接让我看看，说研究三个月了。这份报告披露了美国情报机构如何凭空捏造出一个中国黑客组织。他们声称，这个黑客组织从2021年开始持续攻击美国的重要通信基础设施，组织名叫台风。报告拆解了他们的行动阶段和漏洞，里面大部分是美西方的惯用抹黑手段，但其中一个名字吸引了我的注意，中曾根。他曾是美国陆军将军，一手领导了美国网络战的战略布局。那他在这次诬陷中国的行动里干了什么？根据2023年5月24日美国情报界发布的那篇黑客攻击指控报告，排在编写机构首位的是美国国家安全局 NSA， 美国国防部管理的情报机构，而中曾根就是当时的美国国家安全局局长，他还是时任美国网络司令部的司令，同时是情报机构和军方组织的头头。
可以说在当时的美国情报界，他是当之无愧的领导者。有这样一位领导者，这次行动理应布局周密，但从朋友给我的报告来看，他们的这次行动可以说是漏洞百出，只需要通过技术比对就能发现福特台风组织的网络特征和之前就已经爆出过的黑客组织特征高度相似。也就是说，美国情报机构拿着过去的案件改了个名儿，就要把帽子扣在中国的头上，福特台风组织明显另有其人。
那么为什么这次有明显漏洞还要赶鸭子上架呢？中曾根首次提及福特台风是在他退休的前一天，在此之前他一直没有露出这张底牌，而是一直在说一个条款，外国情报监视法第702条。根据这个条款，美国情报界可以收集美国境外特定外国行为者的通信数据，总统每天早上做决策的情报来源其中三分之二就是靠这个条款的授权。这么重要的条款，为什么还要中曾根反复强调呢？和福特台风又有什么关系？
根据美国外国情报监视法院公开的法庭文件，702条款被滥用的行为记录一年内就有近30万起，
美国人随时有可能因为碰巧与外国监视目标有联系而被美国情报界窃听，所以相当数量的美国人反对这个条款。但迫在眉睫的是，这个条款将在福特台风出现的半年后过期，因此中曾根领导的美国情报界急切需要一次被攻击来说服美国民众。
恰好中曾根在一次发言中曾特意提到需要702条款来防范中国，而这个福特台风刚好被指控来自中国。
我很好奇中曾根为什么这么执着，于是我把他的视频和文字资料都看了一遍，在他退休后发表的一篇专栏文章，我似乎找到了答案。
什么严重错误，是他在伊拉克战场看到的美军在全球情报传输受限，还是他号称别国对美国发动网络攻击？为了避免犯下严重错误，他牵头美国网军主动出击，这样避免了犯下严重错误吗？我不知道。但今天美国成为了全球最大网络攻击来源国，而他成为全球最大情报监控网络的牵头人。
就在不到一个月前，这位退休的军人加入美国风头极盛的人工智能公司 OpenAI 的董事会，并加入其中的安全与保障委员会。中曾根的执念让他放不下702条款。当他把这个执念带进 OpenAI， 会给接下来的 AI 时代带来什么？当我们与 AI 互动时，另一头会多一个监视者吗？这就是以 OpenAI 为首的 AI 公司所期待的未来吗？
中美的这种对抗不可避免，是吧？所以很多年前我就说嘛，啊，中美呢找一个地方来一场决战，是吧？南海是最好的一个地方啊，打服了一个，这世界就太平了。南海多好的地方，是不是各位？这个全面的决战是不可避免的，了解了没有？今天又传来的消息，啊，要推动全面抗中法案了，对抗以中国为首的轴心，这回直接就把那个中国给封为邪恶轴心国的老大了啊，看见没有？美国啊，国会众议院的议长迈克尔·约翰逊表示，中国对全球和平构成最大的威胁，国会将在本届会期结束前致力通过一系列针对中国的立法法案，包括制裁协助俄罗斯、伊朗的中国的军工企业，限制对中国的投资，以及解决中国滥用美国贸易法的法规漏洞等问题。啊，你看见没有？那位说，那干脆就干呗。
Today, we don't face one primary enemy as we did in the Soviet Union, and so far, thankfully, we don't see a new kind of tripartite pact. But we do see a group of nations openly aligned against the United States. It's an interconnected web of threats.I refer to it as a China-led axis composed of partner regimes in Russia, Iran, North Korea, Venezuela, and even Cuba. Now, they each have their own cultures and their own specific sinister aims, but they all wake up every morning thinking how they can take down America. And they are increasingly using their collective military, technological, and financial resources to empower one another in their various efforts.To cut off our trade routes and steal our technology and harm our troops and upend our economy. But because at this moment, China poses the greatest threat to global peace, Congress must keep our focus on countering China with every tool at our disposal. In the short time remaining in this Congress, we're busy at this already. The House will be voting on a series of bills to empower the next administration to hit our enemies' economies on day one. We'll build our sanctions package,punish the Chinese military firms that provide material support to Russia and Iran, and we'll consider options to restrict outbound investments in China. We're working on a piece of legislation to move this fall to do that very thing. We will vote on the BioSecure Act, which will halt federal contracts with biotech companies that are beholden to adversaries and endanger Americans' healthcare data. We'll rein in the de minimis privilege for any good subject to Section 301, trade enforcement tariffs.And that will help stymie China's attempts to exploit American trade. Our goal is to have a significant package of China-related legislation signed into law by the end of this year in this Congress, featuring these priorities and many more, and we'll work aggressively toward that package.
所以说，中国呢，其实已经明白了啊，既然这场对决不可避免的话，那就放弃幻想。准备斗争吧，点个订阅，咱们下期再聊。